Hello and welcome to our channel. This time we will be presenting Hive, an abstract game for two players in which you must protect your queen bee from the attacks of different insects. It may resemble chess, but one of its special features is that it doesn't have a board. The game is suitable for people over 9 and has a length of about 20 minutes. Let's see what Hive is about. In addition to a rulebook and a bag, the game includes two sets of black and white hexagonal tiles with the following insects carved on them: 2 queen bees, 4 spiders, 4 beetles, 6 grasshoppers, and 6 soldier ants. There are also 3 expansions with an additional insect each. They will add 2 mosquitoes, 2 ladybirds, and 2 pill bags to the base game. The game preparation is very simple. Each player takes all the insects of one color, white or black, and places them in front of them. Then, randomly decide who will be the starting player, and you will be ready to start playing. There are several restrictions that all players must bear in mind during the game. The first one is the single hive rule. At all times, the tiles in play must be linked to each other. If not, 2 hives will be created, resulting in a band movement. So, each time you add an insect, it must be joined to the hive. When moving a tile that is already part of the hive, players must be careful not to separate the hive in two. Another important restriction is the freedom of movement rule. With the exception of the grasshopper and the beetle, the rest of the pieces move in a sliding movement. If a tile is surrounded by 5 or 6 of its sides, it can no longer slide out without moving any of the adjacent tiles. Therefore, it will be blocked and cannot move until it is released. Similarly, no piece may move into a space that it cannot physically slide into. But, as we have said before, the grasshopper and the beetle move in a jumping movement. Consequently, they are not affected by this restriction. Now, let's focus on the normal development of the game. First, the starting player must place one of their tiles in the center of the playing surface. The opponent will perform the same action by putting one of their insects linked to one of the 6 sides of the tile already played. From now on, players can perform one of the following actions during their turn: place a new tile or move one of those already in the hive. However, players won't be able to move their insects until their queen bee has been placed in the hive. This must happen within the first 4 turns of the game. When placing a new tile, bear in mind that it cannot touch any of your opponent's tiles. This action is only allowed on the first turn at the beginning of the game, or when moving an already placed tile. If on your turn, you decide to move one of the pieces that are already in play, you will have to take into account the type of insect that you're moving in order to use the movement assigned to it. But how do the insects move? These are all the possible movements for each tile. Let's start with the ones from the base game. Queen bees can only slide one space per turn. In this case, it could only move to the following places. Beetles can only move one space per turn. It can also climb on top of any adjacent tiles, leaving that piece immobilized until the beetle moves away from it. When placing a new tile next to a stacked beetle, we must take into account the color of the visible piece, that is, the one on top. In this case, we have a white tile at the top of the pile. Therefore, only the player using the white tiles could put new ones around the pile. Beetles can be stacked on top of each other. There is no limit on the number of tiles that can be stacked up. Grasshoppers jump over one or more pieces in a straight line to the first unoccupied space of the row of tiles. They cannot jump over empty spaces, since they have to fill them. Spiders move exactly 3 spaces around the hive per turn. They must move in a direct path, never backtrack on themselves, and must remain in contact with the hive at all times during their move. Soldier ants move around the edge of the hive as many spaces as the player wishes. In this example, there is one place where the ant could not move, since it wouldn't be able to slide through it. Now, we will explain the movements of the bugs from the expansions. Mosquitoes are wild. They can copy the movements of any of the creatures they are touching. If move as a beetle to the top of the hive, they continue to move as a beetle until they climb down. If they are only touching another mosquito, they may not move. They must wait to have another insect next to them to be able to copy its movements and move again. Ladybirds must move exactly 3 spaces, 2 on top of the hive and then 1 down. That is, the first movement will be to move to the top of the hive, the second one to move to another piece on top of the hive, and the third one to go down back to the hive. They may not move around the hive, and they must not end their movement on top of it. Pillbugs can perform one of the following movements. On the one hand, they can move one space exactly like the Queen Bee does. On the other hand, they can use their special ability. They can move any adjacent and stack tile. First, they will move it up onto themselves, and then down into another empty space adjacent to them. There are several things to bear in mind about this special ability. Pillbugs can move a tile which was just moved by the other player. They may not move any piece in a stack of tiles. They cannot move a tile if it splits the hive. They may not move a tile through a narrow gap of stacked pieces. A mosquito will be able to copy the movement and the special ability of the pillbug. The other player won't be able to use the piece just moved by the pillbug on their next turn. This would be all the movements of the insects of the hive. The game ends when one of the player's queen bees is completely surrounded by tiles of any color. The game may also end in a draw, either when the last piece to surround a queen bee also completes the surrounding of the other bee, or when both players are in a position where they are forced to move the same two pieces over and over again. Hive is an amusing and addictive game which will hardly ever result in a single round. Its simple setup and straightforward rules make it an easy game to play. However, it does require a high level of concentration to foresee your opponent's next move while you plan your own defense and attack strategies. Thinking several steps ahead and finding different alternatives is a must in order not to be surprised by your opponent. The more you play this game, the better you will be at it. You will learn new tactics that will result in more complex and entertaining games. Moreover, Hive changes a lot depending with whom you play it, making each game totally different from the previous one and providing you with hours of entertainment. In addition, it is an affordable game that doesn't require a lot of space to store or play it. Its pocket version is an excellent choice. The packaging might be a little bit basic, but the quality and size of the pieces are good enough to play it without any problems. For all these reasons, Hive is one of our favorite abstract games. We hope to read your comments about this game with awesome insects. Remember, if you have enjoyed watching our video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to be up to date with our latest videos, subscribe to the channel and click the bell. We will continue playing in the next video.